Lecture, we shall study the solution of system of linear equations using consistency. Already one type of problems we studied by verifying the rank of the matrices. Now another type of problem, let me explain how the solution can be obtained even though the given system of linear equations has got the consistency. That means there exists a consistency, rank of the coefficient matrix is the same as rank of the augmented matrix, and how the system of linear equations produce the solution, let us see from this problem. Example is like this. Test for consistency and solve. The problem takes the statement like this, and the equations are x plus 2y minus z equal to 1, 3x minus 2y plus 2z equal to 2, 7x minus 2y plus 3z equal to 5. As usual, we have to write the matrix equation by representing the coefficients of all these unknowns x, y, z in the coefficient matrix symbol, and then column matrix is to be multiplied with unknowns. On the right side, the values of the constants, that is b1, b2, b3, respectively from the given equations as b1 equal to 1, b2 equal to 2, and b3 is equal to 5. In the solution, let ax equal to b. From this, ax equal to b means it is called the matrix equation beta. Be the matrix equation. Then we will write 1, 3, 7, 2, minus 2, minus 2, minus 1, plus 2, and 3, and column matrix x, y, z equal to 1, 2, and then 5. So this is the matrix equation, and Ax equal to b. A takes the coefficient matrix, X takes the column matrix for unknowns, and B takes the values of the constants from the given equation. Then, this is the pivotal element, and we have to find the rank of the coefficient matrix and rank of the augmented matrix. So, instead of writing separately coefficient matrix and augmented matrix, let us apply the row operations as it is from the given matrix, assuming that this is also included for the calculation purpose and for the comparison purpose of the ranks. Okay. These two elements we have to make them as zero with the help of the pivotal element as non-zero number. This is pivotal element, means leading element, and these two elements are to be made as zero. Then this is R1. This row is R1, this row is R2, this row is R3. Elementary row operation procedure takes operate R1 on R2 and R3 so as to make these two column elements as 0 for the first step. Okay. I will write like this, minus 3 R1 plus R2 effective on R2, minus 7 R1 plus R3 effective on, that is R3. So we will see what values we are getting after these operations which are applied on the given rows. Okay. So here this is equivalent to 1 as it is, 2 as it is, minus 1 as it is. Okay. And then here it is 0, and x, y, z. that is equal to, this is 1, and here that is minus 3 R1, this becomes 0. Minus 3 means that is 6 with minus 6, and then this becomes minus of 8. And minus 3 here, that becomes 5, and minus 3 here, that becomes minus 1. And minus 7, this is 0, and minus 7 here, 14. Minus 14, this becomes minus 16, and minus 7, this becomes plus 7, this is 10, and minus 7, this becomes minus 2. This is one time row operation, that means in the step 1 row operation procedure is completed. We take the help of first row and it is to be operated on the remaining two rows. That is first row on second, first row on third. So with these operations we have taken elementary row operation technique. Now this becomes the pivotal element. The element below that first element, after the first element in the second row, second element below that will have to be converted as 0. Therefore, row operation you have to apply here, and that is to be multiplied previously, and then simply you have to add it to the remaining rows. That means here minus 8 is there, minus 16 is there. If you get plus 16, then it becomes 0. Then what is the coefficient you have to multiply to the previous one? That becomes minus of 2 R2 plus R3, effecting on R3. If you take the multiplication for this minus 8 by minus 2, you will get plus 16, and add it to the remaining means this becomes minus 16. The calculation gives us the value as 0. Then you have to write that is equivalent to 1, 2, minus 1, 0, minus 8, and then 5. This is 0, this is 0. X, Y, Z. This is equal to 1, minus 1. Now we'll see what is the simplification we are getting after multiplying by minus 2 to the second whole row, complete row. So minus 2 here, this becomes 0, plus 10 and minus 10, and minus 2, this also becomes 0. Therefore, what is the rank of the coefficient matrix and what is the rank of the augmented matrix? So both we have to compare. Here, rank of coefficient matrix A equal to R of A equal to R of A means only you have to count from this. Number of non-zero rows is equal to rank of the coefficient matrix. So number of non-zero rows means this is zero row, and these two are called non-zero rows. So zero row and non-zero rows. Therefore, non-zero rows are 2 and zero row is 1. Therefore, you will say that rank of the coefficient matrix is 2. Then, similarly, rank of the augmented matrix, that is A, B, that is equal to R of AB. Coincidentally, this number is also 0. That means this is first row, this is second row, this is third row. The entire third row consists of the numbers as 0. That means there is no non-zero number. Hence, we consider that last row as 0 row. Therefore, this is also 2. Because in the second row, non-zero numbers are present. Therefore, we say that this is the rank 2, this is the rank 2, and both are same, implies R of A is equal to R of, that is equal to 2. What is your conclusion? The given system the given system is said to be consistent. The given system is said to be consistent. When once it is said to be consistent, means there exists a solution. When there exists a solution, how the solution for this type of simplification, that you have to check. Okay, then what is the solution? Here you have to reconstruct the equations. That should be 1 into x plus 2 into y minus z equal to 1. First equation remains to be same. First equation always remains to be same, and second equation we will consider with the corresponding multiplications. What is the first equation? X plus 2y minus z equal to plus 1, and y, that is minus 8 y, and plus 5 z equal to minus 1. And last one, 0 into z is equal to 0. When once it is said to be consistent, accordingly you have to reconstruct the equations. Now, what you are getting the solution at the end? You are getting from this, z equal to, it is 0 divided by 0. So, what is your conclusion about 0 divided by 0? It is called, 0 divided by 0 is called indeterminate form. So you cannot consider that value actually is equal to 0. 0 divided by 0 is nothing but in the indeterminate form, that is to be further considered for some value. So that here we don't have any function, we don't have any equation in numerator and equation in the denominator. Were the equations given in both numerator and denominator, we would have taken the differentiation and then we would have concluded. So now this is 0 divided by 0, we will directly consider as indeterminate form, and we will consider this value as some parameter say. We do not know the value of that, because there we apply L'Hospital rule in order to conclude the value of that particular indeterminate form, then we will achieve the definite value of that particular limit. But here this is the value of 0 by 0 is equal to k, we take, we do not know, but k will take 3 different values. K is less than 0, k is greater than 0, and k is equal to 0. Then other values also we will write in terms of k, like this. So from this second equation we will consider minus 8y plus 5k plus 5k is equal to minus 1. This implies minus 8y is equal to minus 1 minus 5k. Therefore, y is equal to 1 plus 5k and divided by 8. So this is the value of y. Still, the value of y is not final, because k may be 0, k may be less than 0, k may be greater than 0. So that we consider that takes infinite number of values. Therefore, from the first equation, x value you have to consider, that is x plus of 2y, that is plus of 2 into this value, 1 plus 5k by 8, and in place of z we put it as minus k, because z equal to k and z is equal to plus 1. Now you simplify, the value of x, that is equal to, value of x is equal to 1 minus 2, that is into 1 plus 5k divided by 8, and that is a minus, after minus this becomes plus sign. This is the value of x. You can simplify further to take the LCM, and then you can write the final value of that. But anyway, this is the value of z, this is the value of y, and this is the value of x. Therefore, three values we are getting in terms of k. Then k may be, where we can write k is greater than 0, k is equal to 0, k is less than 0. So we do not know the value. So whatever the value of k you are going to assign, thereby we will write the value of k by taking the given value, and then we will write the particular value of that quantity. That means that quantity means x equal to what value, y is equal to what value, and z is equal to what value. That is in terms of k we are going to write. Now we shall see another variety of the problem in the same discussion, that is consistency and inconsistency. We will see that. I shall take another example how the solution behaves in the next example. Test for consistency. And solve. Test for consistency and solve. That is 2x plus 6y equal to minus 11. 6x plus 20y minus 6z equal to minus 3. 6y minus 18z equal to minus 1. Here you have slightly different type of equations. How these equations will give us the solutions that we have to verify. In the solution, as usual, you must write the matrix equation. Let Ax equal to B. Be the matrix equation. Be the matrix equation. Now we will arrange according to that. And here, in the first equation, coefficient of z is not given. Then you have to rewrite the equations. How? That is, in the coefficient matrix 2, that is 6, and then you have to take it as 0 if the symbol is not given. Then 6, it is 20 minus 6, and here 0, that is 6 minus 18. X, Y, Z, that is equal to minus 11 minus 3, and then minus 1. As usual, now we will apply the elementary row operation. We will see that in this one how the solution behaves. That means we have to find out the elementary row operation, and then we have to take the simplification, where the simplification follows in which type of symbol, that we have to verify. Here, this is the pivotal element, and these two elements we have to make them as 0. So, when once we have fixed the pivotal element, that is leading element, always we expect that in that place as non-zero number. So, pivotal element in this case is 2, anyway 2 is a non-zero number, so that we can proceed without any hesitation. Therefore, these two values we have to make them as 0. But with the advantage you have in this set of equations, the third value in this column is already 0. It is appeared as 0, so you need not to operate on the third row. That means you are taking the help of first row to be operated on second, and it is to be operated on third row. But third row is already given itself as 0. Therefore, you have to write minus 3 times R1, 3 into 2, 6 with minus sign, this is R1 plus R2, effecting on R2. This is the only operation that you have to do, not any other operation, because R1 on R2 only you have to do to make this element as 0. But here this element is already given as 0. Therefore, this gives, that is 2, 6, 0, x, y, z, that is minus 11, minus 11, then this is 0, we made it. So minus 3, this becomes plus 2, because 6 3s are 18, and plus 20. Then here, minus 6 only, and this is minus 11, minus 11 into minus 3, that is 33, and minus of 3, that is 30, and this is 0, this is 6, this is 18. We have not made any disturbance here, we have not made any multiplications, so that last row remains to be same. Now, you have to make this element as 0 with the help of this pivotal number. So, pivotal number, leading number, pivotal number or leading number, that is anyway it is a constant. So, that is non-zero number. So, this element you have to make it as 0. Minus 3 R2 plus R3 effecting on R3. You have to make it. Okay. Here 6 is there. You are expecting minus 6 here. Minus 6 plus 6 is equal to 0. Then this is 2, 6, 0, and x, y, z equal to minus 11, 30, and then 0, this is 0, this is 2, minus 6, and this is 0, this is 0, minus 3 R2, minus 3 R2 is, this becomes plus 18, okay. So plus 18, 6 3s are 18 and minus 18, so this becomes 0, last number. And here, this is 3, minus 3, that becomes minus of 90 and minus 1, this is minus 91. Here, if you separate this coefficient matrix and the augmented matrix, when you separate the coefficient matrix and the augmented matrix, because A and that is AB, A is coefficient matrix and AB is augmented matrix. Okay. In this, if you take the calculations or the rank of the matrix observation, then here rank of A. Rank of A means it is a coefficient matrix. So R of A is equal to how much? That is equal to number of non-zero rows. So number of non-zero rows means here third row is completely 0. Because this is 0, this is 0, this is 0. Third row is completely 0. Thereby only two rows are left with us. They are called as non-zero rows. So these two rows are called non-zero rows. And then we have to take it as rank is equal to 2. Then R of AB, if you consider this column here, that becomes 3 cross 4, but this number is not 0. Therefore, rank of augmented matrix is equal to 3. You have to write. This is equal to 3. This implies R of A is not equal to R of AB. R of A is not equal to R of AB. This implies the given system. The given system is not consistent. Then no solution. This is the final conclusion. When it is not said to be consistent, then there exists no solution in that problem. Now, so we will find the next, last variety of the problem I would like to solve in this. Whenever some symbols, we call them as parameters, then we have to decide how these equations are to be discussed. Okay, then. The problem is like this. That is also in the same statement, test for consistency and so on. Test for consistency and solve. x plus y plus z equal to 6, x plus 2y plus 3z equal to 10, x plus 2y plus lambda z is equal to mu. So any one of the varieties you can expect for the examination point of view. In this problem there are two symbols given, one is lambda, another one is mu. First equation is x plus y plus z equal to 6, x plus 2y plus 3z equal to 10, x plus 2y plus lambda z is equal to mu. First of all you operate the elementary row operation on the given equations by writing matrix equation. Afterwards you give your discussion in detail. Okay, then solution. Now from this system of equations, let ax equal to b, be the matrix equation. Ax equal to b in the matrix equation. Then we write 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1, 3, lambda, x, y, z. And on the right side, 6, 10, mu.
That means this equation is incomplete in case if you do not assign the values of lambda and mu in your final discussion. So what values you are going to assign for lambda and mu, your solution depends or your conclusion depends on those values which you are going to assign.
Okay. So now these two elements we have to make them as zero with the help of this pivotal element.
And it is sure in this pivotal element, that means leading element is already 1. This is said to be non-zero number. Anyway, that we can proceed for writing the elementary row operation.
Okay. Simply I can write like this, R1 minus R2 effecting on R2 and R1 minus R3 effecting on R3. Then I can write 1, 1, 1 and x, y, z and this is 6. Now you have to write R1 minus R2, this is 0. R1 minus R2 minus 1, this is minus 2, R1 minus R2, that is minus 4, this is 0, R1 minus R2 minus 1, R1 minus R3, this is minus 1, R1 minus R3, it is 1 minus lambda, and R1 minus R3, 6 minus mu.
One time row operation, that means operating first row on the second and third is over. Now we have to do the elementary row operation from the second on the third row.
So this is to be the pivotal element and this is to be converted as zero. Okay, then what we have to do here is now we have to take this element as zero, but
we have multiplied to the second row by the non-zero number.
First row we kept it as constant. We will see that how this simplification is. This is second row, that means R2 minus of R3
affecting on R3 to make these
second column last element as 0 with the help of
a pivotal element as second element in the second row.
So what is to be done now? 1, 1, 1, 0, minus 1, minus 2, next 0, 0, x, y, z.
Do not operate anything on x, y, z, because we are operating between the numbers, not with the unknowns.
and here it is 6 and minus 4. Okay. R2 minus R3 means, that is lambda with plus sign, this is minus 3 and plus lambda, minus 3 plus lambda between these two, and here minus 10 plus of mu.
This is what. Now the elementary row operation method is completed because we have the options only, that is first row on second and third and second row on the third row.
Now that procedure is over.
Only thing, the rest of the part that you have to do only for the interpretation of the system.
Okay, here now we have to make from this system, that means this final step, you have to make three important discussions. What are those three important discussions? Now, case one. If this quantity is zero, if this quantity is not zero,
what is your conclusion? The previous problem we discussed.
If this is zero, then the rank of the coefficient matrix is 2, and rank, if this is not zero, and rank of the augmented matrix is 3. Therefore, it is said to be inconsistent, then the solution does not exist. Now we can write, if minus 3 plus lambda is equal to 0 and minus 10 plus mu is not equal to 0.
If this is equal to 0,
this quantity, and if this is not equal to 0, then this implies the given system, is inconsistent.
The given system is said to be inconsistent,
then that implies no solution.
There exists no solution.
Then, case 2. If minus 3 plus lambda equal to 0 and minus 10 plus mu equal to 0,
then what is your conclusion?
Here, this no solution means this is said to be R of A is not equal to R of AB in the first case. If this is equal to 0, this is also equal to 0, implies R of A equal to rank of coefficient matrix is equal to 2 is equal to R of AB.
Since the entire third row will become 0, will be consisting of the elements of 0,
then we will say that this last row is said to be 0 row and only 2 rows are left. Therefore, we write rank of coefficient matrix to be equal to 2.
That is the same as rank of the augmented matrix as 2.
Then we say that there exists an infinite number of solutions. How? That means z equal to 0 by 0 is equal to k, where k may be greater than 0, k may be equal to 0, k may be less than 0.
With this, then we will explain the value of y in terms of k and the value of x in x also in terms of k.
Thereby we can say that there gives, that gives an infinite number of solutions. Then, last case. What is the last case? Last case means unique solution.
One is no solution, another one is infinite number of solutions, and one more is unique solution.
What is that unique solution? Case 3. What is that? If in this case minus 3 plus lambda is not equal to 0 and that is mu, sorry, minus 10 plus mu is also not equal to 0.
That means third row, the entire row is not containing all the elements as 0. That means you cannot declare that entire third row as 0 row. But the system is said to be consistent when the rank of coefficient matrix is the same as rank of the augmented matrix.
So this we will consider R of A is equal to 3 is equal to R of AB. This implies the system is consistent, then there exists a unique
solution. So thereby this problem is a little important, because in terms of lambda and mu you have to discuss. In terms of lambda and mu you have to discuss means you have to completely, depending on the values which you are going to assign for mu and lambda.
Now if mu is equal to 3, lambda is equal to 3 and mu is equal to 10, and that is nothing but
the same three cases what we discussed in the other way. Okay, so with this, all the varieties of the problems which we discussed in this test for consistency and solve. Now I shall write some two or three extra problems so that you can practice. Then I shall explain another topic. So what are those extra problems? You please note down.
The common heading, test for consistency and solve. The first one, 2x1 minus 2x2 plus 4x3 equal to minus 12. 2x1 plus 3x2 plus 2x3 equal to 8 minus x1 plus x2 minus x3 is equal to 7/2. x4 equal to 6. 4x1 plus 3x2 plus 3x3 minus 3x4 is equal to minus 1. 6x1 minus 6x2 6x3 plus 12x4 equal to 36. 2x1 plus 2x2 minus x3 plus x4 is equal to 10.
The second problem is instead of 3 unknowns, I have given 4 unknowns with 4 equations. And same procedure you have to follow and see that 3 times row operations you have to do. How 3 times?
This is row 1, this is row 2, this is row 3, this is row 4. R1 on R2, R3, R4. Next is R2 on R3 and
R4. Next R3 on R4. So totally 3 stages you have to discuss for the elementary row operation method, and then you have to declare what are your answers. Anyway, solutions I can give for this.
For this one, solutions are x equal to 2, that is x1, and x2 is equal to 1, x3 is equal to minus 1, and x4 is equal to 3. You can verify these values which I am getting like this, and you can apply these values in the equation so that
we can verify equation also whether it is going to be satisfied or not.
Okay, so this is one problem. Next one. X plus 2y plus 2z equal to 1 and 2x plus y plus z equal to 2, 3x plus 2y plus 2z equal to 3.
These three problems you try, even in you can also consider some extra problems from the list of problems which are available in the textbooks. So with this test for consistency and solve, this procedure is over. So now we shall move on to the another method which is included in the syllabus, that is called Gauss elimination method. So Gauss elimination method, in this one we consider, we are not going to consider the consistency, but we will consider the step by step elimination. That step by step elimination is nothing but alternate method for Gauss elimination consistency is called Gauss elimination method. How this works? Same elementary row operation method you do that, but you need not to check the consistency, but you can solve those equations. Okay, now
let me explain about the Gauss elimination method. This is also called as alternate method.
Alternate method of elementary row operation. Here also we will apply the same elementary row operation method. Even elimination is nothing but eliminate x from all the three equations, eliminate y in the second stage from all the three equations, then you can collect the value of z. This is the procedure. That is what we have been doing in elementary row operation method. Okay.
Here, we eliminate x, y, z successively either solving with the pair of equations or by row operation method. Or by row operation method. Let me take an example directly. We can go to the problem and then we can understand,
because already elementary row operation method you are familiar. All these problems we have solved, and we will we will apply the same procedure for this problem also.
Let us verify. Example. Apply Gauss elimination method. To solve that is 3x plus y plus z equal to 4, then x plus 2y plus 2z equal to 3, 3x plus y plus 3z equal to 4. These are the three equations.
Already same equations what you have discussed earlier, you can simply call them by the statement of the question, apply Gauss elimination method, and hence you can solve the system of equations.
Same. Now in the solution, first you have to write the matrix equation. Write 2 matrix equation. equal to B.
Writing to the matrix form, that is AX equal to B.
Then how this is to be applied by elementary row operation method. That is, we have to write 3, 1, 3, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, 3, these numbers. Then x, y, z, this is 4, 3, 4 as constants. Okay, so now you have to write what are the row operations you have to do it. So pivotal element is, that is 3, then these two numbers you have to make them as 0. Okay, then what you have to do? 3 times, R1 minus 3 times R2 affecting on, that is R2.
In any way you can do that.
Either 1 by 3 R1 minus 1 by 3 R1 plus R2 affecting on R2.
In any way you can do that. But for both the rows you do not multiply, only to the only to one of the two rows you have to multiply and then
add it to the remaining. Okay. The next one. That is R1 minus R3 affecting on R3. So that becomes, first row remains to be same, 3, 1, 1, and x, y, z. Then this is equal to 4. Then this is 0. R1 minus 3 times R2. R1 minus 3 times R2. R1 minus 3 means 3 2s are 6. This is minus 5. Then R1 minus 3 2s are 6. This is also minus 5. R1 minus 3, that is 9. It is also minus 5. Then this is 0. R1 minus R3, this is 0. Then R1 minus R3. So R1 minus R3 means, that is minus of 2. R1 minus, this is R4. Okay. That is R1 minus R3. That is 1 minus 3 is minus 2. And 4 minus 4 is 0. Okay. So now,
Operating first row on second and third is over. Now, you have to take the chance of operating second row on the third row. But fortunately, this is already coming in the calculation procedure itself, steps itself. Already this has been 0. So we need not to convert that number 0 with the help of 5. But anyway, our goal is to convert to the element below that pivotal element as 0, so that elementary row operation procedure method can be applied.
Then the procedure is over, you have to reconstruct the equation. Here we don't consider what is the consistency or what is the rank of the matrix. That is completely not to be discussed here. Only you have to apply elementary row operation, step by step you are eliminated. That means here x is eliminated, here y is eliminated. Now z value easily you can collect. So what is that? Minus 2z equal to 0, therefore z equal to 0. Next, another equation is minus 5y minus 5, this is minus 5z equal to minus 5. Okay, then what is that? So z equal to 0, already we got minus 5y is equal to minus 5, then y is equal to, that is 1. Next, another one, 3x plus y plus z equal to 4. So z is already 0 and y is already 1, then 3x is equal to 4 minus 1. So this is 3, then 3x, then x equal to 1. So x equal to 1, y equal to 1 and z is equal to 0. That means you have to write x equal to 1, y is equal to 1 and z equal to 1. Suppose you want to test the equation 3x plus y plus z equal to 4. For example, first equation, you substitute these values there and your equation is to be satisfied. That is what your conclusion that you have to do it. So 3 into 1 plus 1 plus 0 is equal to 4. This is 4 is equal to 4.
Your solution is correct. Therefore, Gauss elimination method which will take the solution in this way.
Now, I shall take another example by the same Gauss elimination method. Minus 6y plus 8z equal to 24, 5x plus 4y minus 3z equal to 2, 3x plus y plus 2z equal to 16.
This you can solve by Gauss elimination method using the same type of procedure, that means elementary row operation method you have to apply.
So, first of all, we will write in the solution matrix equation. Let Ax equal to B be the matrix equation.
Ax equal to B be the matrix equation. Then, what you have to do?
You have to apply the elementary operation by taking the pivotal element. You have to write the coefficient matrix, that is 2, 5 and then 3, minus 6, 4 and then 1, and here 8 and then minus 3, 2, multiplied to x, y, z, and this is equal to 24, then 2, and then 16. Now, these two elements you have to write them as 0
with the help of the pivotal element.
Then, what you have to do? So, this becomes 2 is there and 5 is there, okay? Then, minus 5 by 2 R1 plus R2, effecting on it is R2. This is 3 is there. Minus 3 by 2 R1 plus R3 effecting on R3 to make the column elements as 0, in the respective column elements as 0. Then, so what this becomes? This becomes 2 minus 6, 8, x, y, z, and then 24, and then it is 0, minus 5 by 2 here. Okay. So, minus 5 by 2 into minus 6 plus 4. 2 3s are 6, that is 5 3s are 15 plus 4, it is 19. Next, minus 5 by 2, it is R1, that is 8, and minus of 3, 2 4s are 8, that is minus 20, that is minus of, it is 23. So, minus 5 into 4, it is minus 20, and minus 3, it is minus 23. Here, minus 5 by 2, minus 5 by 2 into R1, 24, and plus 2, that is 2 12s are minus 60, this is 58, this is one number, then 0. Here, 3 by 2, R1, so 3 by 2 with minus, that is R1, 3 by 2 R1 into minus 6, then plus 1. 2 3s are 6, that is 3 3s are 9 plus 1. This is 10. Next, minus 3 by 2 into 8 and plus 2. 2 4s are 8, that is 12. In this, it is minus of 10. Okay, next 24, that is minus 3 by 2 into 24 and plus 16, 2 12s are 36, minus 36, 16, this is 20, okay, that is minus of 20. So, all these calculations are possible when you are going to operate from the
first row on the remaining.
So now you have to write this element as 0 with the help of 19. Minus 10 by 19, minus 10 by 19, that is R2 plus this is R3, affecting on R3. Therefore, 2, 0, 0, that is minus 6, 19, 0, 8, minus 23, then x, y, z, and this is equal to 24 minus 58, and then you have to write these two elements. Minus 10 by 19, 19 into R2, this is 23, okay, and minus of 10. So whatever it is there, you have to write minus 230, minus 230, that is 23 into this much, minus 230 by 19 and minus 10. And here, this is minus 10 by 19 into 58 with plus sign and minus of 20. So this is 0.80 divided by 19 and minus of 20. So this
Procedure of applying elementary row operation is completed.
Then you have to reconstruct the equations by taking the LCM, by taking the LCM here also, and do the simplification. So we will take the simplification here. Minus 230 and minus of 190 divided by 19. Okay, this is 0, that is 2, and this is 4. So minus 420 divided by 19. And here, this is 580 minus of, this becomes 380, that is 19 twos are 38, that is 38 means 380, 4 divided by 19. So this becomes 2 here, and then 7 remains, that is 2, and then 3. So this is with minus 322, this is 19, okay. Then here in this case, you can write, what is that number? That is minus of 420 divided by 19. And here you can write the simplification, minus 322 and divided by 19. So applying the elementary row operation method is completed. Now you have to solve the equation. Okay. So first equation as it is 2x minus 6y plus 8 is equal to 24. Second equation, 19y minus 23z, this is equal to 58. And next is minus 420 by 19, z equal to minus 322 divided by 19.
You have to solve these equations. You need not to verify the consistency of these equations.
So that 19 cancels, then z takes the value minus 322 divided by minus 420. This is z value. Then 19y is equal to 58, then 23 into z value, that comes to the right side, plus of, this is minus, here minus minus, plus it is, then 322 divided by 420 into this is 23. So whatever the simplification we are getting, you write, and y is equal to 1 by 90 and 58 into 420 plus 23 into 322 whole divided by 420. So whatever the value of y you are getting, you write it. And substitute these two values in x, therefore x takes the value, that is 1 by 2 into 24, this is 8z, minus 8z, minus of 8 into z value, 322 divided by 420, and minus of 6y, okay. So y value is this much, and minus 6y, right? If you take to the right side, the 6 is to be multiplied. Therefore, plus 6 by 19, and whatever this value you have, you have to write completely
that number. That becomes the value of
x. Therefore, x equal to this much, y equal to this much, z equal to this much
Will be the solution for the given system of linear equations using Gauss elimination method. With this, I shall continue the problems in the next lecture.